We are in the Sal forest, Porhat forest of Ranchi. So this area is coming under Ranchi territorial division. This forest is predominantly having a species called Shorea robusta that is commonly called as sakua in Jharkhand. In Jharkhand, this tree is facing a threat because of intensive felling and other degradatory measures like mining and rampant felling, etc. So the trees you are seeing around are some of the few mother trees which are existing in Ranchi area. So regarding conservation purpose of sal tree, we must know about how it is getting propagated. Actually, this seeds of sal having a viability of only 1 week, so as soon as the sal tree fell on the ground, there must be humus and there must be enough amount of soil to protect that seed and make it congenial for its germination. So now what is happening in Jharkhand is that because of excessive grazing and other degradation, there is no undercover and therefore there is no humus, and it is a kind of a plantation kind of thing, and the seeds which are fallen down is falling on a barren ground where there is no topsoil, and it is it fails to germinate. So the process of germination is stopped there, and so that is why the new generation of sal is not coming up. So there is a dire need of protecting this sal trees of Jharkhand, because it is the most common species in Jharkhand, and for the purpose of its protection, the major thing we must focus on is protecting it from the entry of human beings and domestic animals. And some water conservation approach also, if we include in that area, can very well protect the sal patches of Jharkhand. Initially, it was difficult for me to gel with my cadre, but as soon as I landed here and I saw the beauty of this forest, the first thing attracted me was the flowers, the various colors of the forest of Jharkhand. See, the sal flowering time is during summer, and it is having beautiful fragrance, and when it flowers, the whole forest will be having that fragrance, and it will attract to you to that forest. And there are so many aesthetic and cultural values of the sal, you know, the tribals, local tribals consider this as a sacred tree, and during its flowering they conduct a festival called Sarhul. So if they used to worship the tree in the Sarnastal, it's a place where it's a kind of a sacred grove you might have heard of. So they will worship the tree and they will wear the sal flowers on their head, and all the ladies will wear beautiful white and red bordered saris, and they will dance, and it is basically worshipping the nature, and nature is sal tree symbolizing the nature. And one beautiful thing about sal is that during the wedding ceremony, and they will make an altar with small sal poles, and the bridegroom has to sit in that altar. Then only that wedding ceremony is considered as auspicious. Without that, they will not conduct that ceremony. So, and they used to nimantran that card from, they will used to give that leaf with having some rice flakes and kumkum in that, and they will give it to you wedding card, and they will invite you for the wedding. And sal is it's a part of the culture of the original people of Jharkhand. They will make plates out of that, and there are so many. I may not be knowing so many things. They use the seed and seed oil to cook food, and the resins are also, resin is used for dhoop, and n number of uses. And you know, this sal forest is a rich source of medicinal plants, mushroom, and if you go to Parishnath Hills, it is like the valley of Parachnath Hill is a huge source of medicinal plants. So it is basically the sal. If there is no sal, this undercover is gone, the medicine plants gone, the mushroom gone, the livelihood gone. So there is a dire need. There is we must conserve sal, and it is, I think, it's the right time that we are taking. We notice this is happening, and we must do something about the sal tree. And I think if we are not saving the sal tree, we cannot save Jharkhand.